Hi everyone, my name is Vivek and this is the second episode to create switchable grid using Vue.js. If you are new to my channel, then please don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon so you never miss out my new tutorials. In the previous session, we cloned and ran the static switchable grid site. Today, we'll show the dynamic data using Axios. We will also resolve the course issue because our site is hosted locally and our data is hosted at other domain. First of all, let's install Axios using the command line as this will help to call API request in Vue.js. So open your text editor and in this terminal you can press Ctrl C to stop the server and you can type npm install Axios. Once it is installed, you can run the site again using npm run serve. Now, to use Axios, we can follow this documentation from Vue's official website. I have provided this link in the description below if you want to know what Axios is, how to use them, along with some examples. So for now, under this data, we will return content and assign a value of null. And under this mounted lifecycle hook, we will use Axios and get the data. And currently our data is over here. Now let's get started. And the first thing we need to do is we have to import Axios from Axios. Then under this data, I will set the value of contents to null. Now we need to add mounted lifecycle hook. So you can copy and paste it over here. And for the data, you can copy this URL and replace it over here. Also, instead of this info, it will be contents. We can now show the data using for loop. So I will go all the way to the top and remove all of this li except the first one. And in first li, I will use the for loop. It will be content in contents, and for key it will be content.id. Now to get image from data, you have to use colon src, and over here it will be content.imageSource. Now let's do same for this list view as well. So again, I will remove all of this li except the first one. Then in li, I will add for loop. So again, it will be content in contents, and the key will be content.id. For image, you have to use colon. And then it will be content.imageSource. For title, you can use interpolation using double curly braces. And title is coming from this title, so it will be content.title. Likewise, the description is coming from here, description. So you can remove and under the curly braces you can add content.description. Now if you check the site, you won't see anything over here, and if you try to use developer tool to check the console error, you can see the error over here saying access to XML HTTP request at this from origin localhost has been blocked by course policy. We normally get this kind of error if we try to get data from different origin or domain. For example, our site is running locally over here, but our data is coming from different domain, bibeksakya.com. So to resolve this issue in Vue, we got some documentation in Vue CLI. I will go to main page of this Vue CLI. Then first you need to click on this config reference link. Then if you don't have this vue.config.js file, you have to create one, and then you have to add module.export. So in my case I don't have that file, so I'll be creating new file called vue.config.js. Then I can add module.exports. Now we have to use something called devserver.proxy. So you can click on this link. You can then copy this devserver and proxy. You can then replace this link with bibeksakya.com, and under this product component you can then use this link of localhost and replace it over here like this. Now you can refresh the site again, and for some reason it is still not showing. Let's check over here, and I did one mistake over here. This vue.config.js, it should be inside this start folder, so I will cut and paste it inside start folder. You can now check the site again, and still there are some issues. So what I will do is I will go back to this product component again and make some small changes over here. So in this response I will add response.data. Now let's check the site again, and this time all the data is showing correctly. Great. This is the end of this session. In the next session we'll work on click events, fee if directive, and add active class based on condition. Feel free to comment below if you have any questions. Also please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel to get more videos in the future. If you want some hosting companies, you can check the link in the description below. Thank you and see you soon.